Well, so we had a little trouble coming in town this afternoon. We usually come in either on the train or on the bus. Except one time, my feller brung me in his car. Oh, I don't like these new cars. You know, no clutch. I like the old-timey ones, you know. Plenty of clutch. My feller and me, I remember one time, my feller let me drive his car. Oh, I never will forget that. I had a funny experience here with one of these traffic cops. I like the cops here in Nashville, and they're always awful nice, except I had a little trouble with just this one. I was trying to drive the car, and I pulled up in front of one of these here lights, these here traffic lights, you know, and I stalled my engine, and I couldn't get no worse. And finally, the light changed red, and then it changed green, and then it changed red, and finally, the cop, he come up to the side of the car, and he said to me, he said, "What's the matter, lady? Ain't we got no colors you like?" Oh, me. And then one time I had trouble coming up here on the bus. And I usually have an awful nice time with them bus drivers. They're real nice to me as a rule. But we was trying, all of us trying to come up here. And there was Mammy and Brother and Sister and Uncle Nabob and Aunt Ambrosie and Elmer and Brother's old dog, Careless. And you know, that old dog, Brother, he calls him Careless. Because he got him for a hunting dog and he cares less about hunting than dog you ever seen. But he's a good old dog, and we was going to bring him with us. And everybody in the family got on the bus, and Brother had that old Careless with a rope tied around his neck trying to pull him on the bus. The bus driver says, "Boy, the bus don't carry dogs. The dog ain't going to be able to get on the bus." Brother says, "Why, we got to have the dog on the bus. He's going with us." And I said to the bus driver, I said, "Mister, that dog is just like a member of the family." And the bus driver said, "Lady, I can see the family resemblance, but the dog still don't ride the bus." Oh, me, we've had a hard time with that old dog. Brother loves him so good. Brother got so upset over him here last year, he got one of his legs cut off. The dog did, not Brother. But the dog got one of his legs cut off, and Brother didn't do a thing but put him a wooden leg on now. Now that's the finest rabbit running dog you ever seen. He not only chases the rabbits, but he catches them and clubs them to death with that wooden leg. Last Christmas, we had so many kin folks come to see us that Brother didn't have no place to sleep, so he had to go out in the barn and sleep. Next morning, I said, "Brother, did you get cold out there in the barn?" Brother said, "No, I just took all my old dogs out there with me. And every time I got cold, I just pulled up another dog." That's it. Only trouble is, about that old dog Careless, is that he chases the train mighty bad. One afternoon, Brother was sitting down there by the railroad track, and a train come through, and that old dog took out after the train. Fella standing there by the railroad track said to Brother, said, "Does that old dog chase the train every time it comes by here?" Brother said, "Yep." He said, "Reckon what makes that dog chase the train?" Brother said, "I ain't never worried about why he chased it. I just wondered what he'd do with it if he caught it." Oh, me. We got mole animals around up there at the house. We got a cat that Brother's tried to get rid of for years. One day, a couple of days ago, Brother decided he'd really get rid of that cat. So he took him about a mile and a half up the road and left him and come back home. A little bit while after that, well, he looked out, the cat was sitting right there on the step, see? Well, that made Brother so mad. So he took that old cat about 5 miles up the road and left him. Come back, a couple of hours later, that old cat was sitting right there on the doorstep. So Brother got really mad then. So he took him away off up in the woods. In fact, he took him so far away that Brother never would have found his own way back if he hadn't followed the cat.